Today's story is Seamore in Hawaii, The Search for the Next Campfire Coach, written by Carol Craven Bates and illustrated by Kari Wimsatt. If you would like a copy of this book, there's a link for it in the description. Chapter 8. Seamore left the area around the auditorium in a flash. As usual, Mike and Ben had to run to catch up with him. The fact that their legs were longer was the only advantage they had. The Smottosaurus was a powerful running machine when he had food on his mind. Going as fast as they could go, the two men finally caught up with the Smotter. They stopped him just a half a block from the beach of the Pacific Ocean. He was heading straight for the water and on to an abundance of food. As Ben managed to pull alongside of Seymour, he reached out his hand and literally turned the Smotter around right in mid-stride. Since the preacher was still trying to catch his breath, Ben spoke first. "Whoa there, little buddy, where are you going in such a big hurry?" The Smottosaurus had a blank expression on his face, along with a glassy, faraway look in his eyes. Mike and Ben were both surprised to discover him in this state. They had never seen Seymour look so disoriented before. The two men could tell from his demeanor that something was seriously bothering him. The preacher and the youth minister looked at each other in disbelief. Mike cleared his throat and asked, "Ben, what do you think is wrong with this little guy?" "I don't know, but it sure looks as if something has him very upset." The preacher tried to think back over the questions asked by those at the meeting to see if he could think of anything that would have upset the Smotter to this degree. The preacher couldn't think of a single thing except for the fact that Miss Daniels and Mr. Haywood had been somewhat rude. Getting down close to his face, Mike asked, "Seymour, did those two people hurt your feelings with their insensitive remarks during the discussion time this afternoon? If so, in the morning, Ben and I will talk to them about being more courteous to you. They need to watch their manners. Sometimes good people say things that come out wrong. They really didn't mean to upset you." With his head spinning and feeling very weak, the Smotter tried to focus on the men standing before him and on the words he was hearing them say. It was no use. The Smottosaurus needed food, and his brain could think of nothing else. In a slurry voice, he groaned, "I really am sorry, guys. It's paramount that I get into the water immediately. My tummy is telling me it's time to go back to the sea." Mike and Ben looked at each other again, neither one of them knowing what to say or do. As they stood there in silence, the Smottosaurus turned to face the ocean and proceeded toward its destination. Just then, the preacher noticed a vendor selling sandwiches from his little booth at the edge of the beach. He ran toward the peddler while Ben chased after the Smotter. In a husky, excited voice, Mr. Barlow yelled, "Quick, give me a dozen hot dogs, a dozen hamburgers, and anything else you can fix in a hurry." While he waited for the food, Mike signaled Ben to stop Seymour from making it back into the water. Right at the edge of the ocean, Ben literally tackled the Smotter and held onto him with both hands. After a short struggle, the Smotter broke free and had one foot already in the water when, just in the nick of time, the preacher came running across the hot sand with both arms fully loaded with food. "Wait, Seymour, wait! I have something here for you to eat. I have food!" At the exact moment the Smottosaurus heard the preacher talking about food, he smelled the delicious aroma. With one foot still in the air, he turned the upper portion of his body toward Mr. Mike. Quick as a flash, Seymour hurried out of the water and back onto the beach. Ben grabbed one of the hamburgers out of a bag and unwrapped it. He handed it to the Smotter as fast as he could. The Smottosaurus woofed down the delicious food in two powerful bites. He reached for another, and this time he was given a hamburger for each hand. After the seventh hamburger was safely inside his tummy, the countenance of the Smotter dramatically changed. He suddenly looked like his old self again, and a smile reappeared on his face. Mike and Ben continued to hand Seymour food until every morsel in all five bags was gone. In a very brief period of time, there was nothing left but one big bag of trash. Shortly after the last bite of food disappeared into his mouth, the Smottosaurus patted his now rounded belly and sighed. Looking right at the two men, he said, Thank you, Mr. Mike and Mr. Ben. That was a good snack. I was fading fast. I couldn't have made it much longer without something to eat. Feeling exhausted, the smotter laid back in the sand on the beach. That food made my tummy feel much better. My body isn't used to all these little bitty snacks. I usually have a couple of really good meals before I do any snacking. Mike and Ben couldn't believe what they were hearing. They didn't speak, but they were both thinking the same thing. How could a Smottosaurus possibly eat so much? And how could he call that much food a snack and not a meal? As they both pondered their thoughts, the smotter blurted out, "Hey, you guys want to go somewhere for supper?" The two men looked at each other and then at Seamore. In unison, they shouted, "No!" Ben cleared his throat. "What we'd like is for you to come back to the convention center in the morning. We need to make a decision on a coach for our campfire meeting. You have a very good chance of getting that job if you're interested." Seymour wrinkled up his brow. "I was wondering why you were having so many powwows back at the convention center. I thought you were just having a meeting so you could get to eat all those donuts. Exactly what is a campfire meeting, and why do you need a coach? Do they eat donuts too?" The two men took a seat in the sand next to the smotter. The preacher seemed anxious to explain. "Seymour, for 6 weeks every summer, Camp Hosanna invites children to come stay in cabins on the campground. Don't you remember me telling you all about camp before we went to the meeting this morning?" "Well, maybe you did, but I seem to have forgotten. I might have been hungry when you were talking about camp, and when I'm thinking about food, nothing else seems to stick in my memory. My tummy has a way of kicking my brain out of gear." Mike laughed. "Yeah, I've noticed that. But just to refresh your memory, we usually have about 150 children come to camp all at the same time. That group stays for a whole week. Then they go home and a new group comes to stay." The Smottosaurus scratched his head as if he was thinking over what Mr. Barlow had said. "Oh, I get it. It's like having a big sleepover." Ben jumped into the conversation. "Almost, Seymour. Before the sleepover each night, we build a big campfire and everyone sits around the fire while the coach tells Bible stories. You see, we're trying to teach children about God." Mike stood up and brushed the sand from his clothes. "That's absolutely right. Whoever we choose as our coach must know how to tell one Bible story after another. Seymour, you seem to be a natural. Ben and I both think you would make an excellent campfire coach." The Smottosaurus sat quietly as he pondered on that thought for just a moment before whispering, "What about the donuts?" Ben grinned and then snickered. "We might be able to rustle you up a few dozen donuts every now and then." With a happy smile on his face, the smotter looked directly at the preacher and then the youth minister. Licking his lips, he stated, "I do like to talk, and I do like to eat donuts. If that's all I have to do, I think I'd like that job." As Ben stood and brushed the sand off his clothes, the smotter jumped up and looked toward the sea. Still facing the water, he declared, "Okie dokie, I'll see you in the morning right after breakfast." Mike and Ben both gave a loud sigh of relief. They were thrilled when they heard Seymour say he would come back in the morning, and even more thrilled when they heard him say he would see them after breakfast. The three said their goodbyes, then the two men watched the Smottosaurus swim out into the ocean for the night.